Each year, millions of sportsmen spend millions of dollars to pursue the wary whitetail. Contrary to reports from anti-hunting organizations, the percent rate of success is considerably low. Is this from lack of effort or desire? Probably not. Most likely, it's from lack of experience and exposure. Any white-tailed deer, regardless of size, can give the average hunter more challenge than he or she would bargain for. To observe this creature of the night from a distance is one thing. To take him at close range is another. You say, I see him all the time, but I just can't seem to connect. Isn't it time you became part of the 10% of hunters that take 90% of game? In this production, the All-American Hunting Team pours out their hearts to help you obtain success. If you have the fever, we have the cure. Whitetail Remedy.
Now, in this video production, we're going to be taking small bucks, does, medium bucks, large bucks. We're going to be taking all sizes of deer. And there's a reason for that. We get thousands of letters from hunters all over the world that are so happy that they finally bagged that trophy doe. Now we're gonna go right into this video and we're gonna show you a doe kill right off the bat, and there's a reason for that. It's necessary to take these does, and we're excited about it. We love it. We're hunters just like you are. Let's go check it out.
Dan climbs up into a huge pine tree overlooking a large hay field on a major run, which is a funnel between the swampy bedding area and the main food source. The thick pines serve as barrier for the approaching deer. Normally, they will hold here for a short waiting period to assure the coast is clear. Being high in a pine allows for maximum concealment, lessening your human scent, which will build your confidence. You must always check your shooting lanes from this height. Be sure you have practiced from this elevation as well. Remember, with sights, your trajectory is going to be different. After checking shooting lanes and making sure nothing will touch our clothes, we are ready. In just a short time, directly below, deer start coming through. Several small bucks come out first, but today, we have to take a doe. Dan is, however, a very dedicated hunter, and he knows the importance in balancing the herd. Looks like a record book doe to me.
You know, there's a lot of ways to ambush a deer. There's a lot of things you can use for blinds. Hay fields, use bales of hay, round bales. But when we're in the brush like this, we just use the brush for a natural blind. We get down like this, you get off the side of a run, you know the deer are gonna come down that run. You're not gonna have a long time to shoot, so you gotta be at full draw when they come out. And when you're in a blind like this, natural, heavy brush, you gotta practice shooting through this stuff. I'll take a shot through here and we'll see how I do. I tell you, when you have a deer walk down a run like that and you gotta shoot through this brush, 9 times out of 10, that deer is not gonna see you in this brush if you're still. But you gotta come to full draw when you get glimpses of that deer coming through. And when he steps out like that, you gotta be able to take that difficult shot. Just like that. And I'll tell you what, if you can do that consistently, you're ready for this kind of ambush. If you can't, then you need to wait on this kind of difficult shot. Let's go see how this works on a live deer.
In a heavy cane thicket, Dan locates a major run, which contains very obvious signs that this is a well-used travel pattern from a bedding area to a food source. Figuring out deer movement is not as difficult as some might think. It just requires a lot of scouting and, most of all, a lot of thinking on our part. Dan, being an engineer, tries to figure out everything he encounters in his life. Deer have natural instincts, but we have the abilities to rationalize and think, to figure things out. Concealed and off of the run, Dan begins to call. Little did he know how quick the calling would produce such excitement in this young buck.
Thank you.
I got something. Look at it. Right down that run.
Y'all got something?
You got it.
Did you get that arrow coming out?
Yep. Guaranteed.
The way he was facing me, like the shot, that dude looked right in there where I was sitting. You see that?
Yep.
The way I shot, I took him right behind the shoulder.
Man, that's a blood trail.
Yeah, it is.
Going right down this run. You won't have no problem finding this dude.
Here he is. He's
got
here.
Him?
All you got to do
you
is
got him?
Stay on the run. You can see him right down the run.
There it is. You got him right behind
his
shoulder.
3, 4, 5, 6. That's a six pointer. There's a shot on my side right there.
You got him good.
Hey,
you got him good.
I just gotta see what happened. Right there, where it came out.
Yep.
I thought it was gonna be back here more. Cause he was angling, I mean, a radical angle. Well, I tell you what, that's a nice six pointer.
Sure.
Beautiful deer.
Hold him up. Let's see that face. All right. That'll work.
You take that?
That'll work.
Perfect six pointer. There's a lot of sixes and fours in here. Perfect sixes and fours on this property.
Man.
I know, you want a perfect 12. Two of these will be a perfect 12.
I want an ugly 9 typical.
Two of these will be a perfect 12.
Yep.
Twice as much meat, too.
Man, that's a beaut.
All deer taken should be considered a trophy. When Dan asks, have you ever made a mock scrape? Some answer, what is a mock scrape? We realize not every sportsman is a seasoned veteran. That's why Dan is invited to speak all over the country.
Bottle, that's the gland out of the eye. It might take a few hours now for our scent to get off of that. It's going to be worth it though.
That's why I asked if you had that straight down on the deer.
Look at that shot.
That's it.